Yes, hello and welcome to my IFR tutorial. This tutorial will be about how to set up a GPS or RNAV approach for a given airport. As you can see on the map, we are located in Florida, close to the D-Land airport. That's Kilo Delta Echo Delta, as you can see here. And our objective today will be setting up a GPS RNAV approach for runway 07 left in Daytona Beach. That's this airport right here. Okay, we are using German GPS. That's the one that's included with the FSX software. It's a GPS 500 model. And for all of those who are not familiar with this GPS, just a quick review here. We have our nearest button. If we click on that, we get the nearest airports. If we use our cursor here, we have to use the big one. Sorry, not the big one, the small one. We get to our next page of intersections, nearest intersections, followed by nearest NDBs, VORs, and airspace. Okay, so the cursor allows you to switch between pages. Now we have the OBS here. If you click on nearest again, it should, but it does not do it. Okay, let's go on flight plan. If you click on flight plan, it will give us our map back. Okay, and now we also have a message button here. Message is currently flashing. Okay, that means GPS, the unit has a message for us. So if we click on message, it will tell us airspace near and ahead. About less than 10 minutes. Okay, in this case they would be talking about the Class Charlie airspace of the Daytona Beach Airport, which is in magenta right here, and we are very close to that, as you can see. Now again, flight plan, it will give us our active flight plan if we have one. At this time we do not have one yet. If we click on it again, it will give us our map back. Then we have TER, which stands for terrain. Okay, we have two different modes. We have a day mode and a night mode. If we click on it, you will see the terrain color will change for day flying. During the night, you can switch it to terrain and have it all in different colors. Now PROC, shortcut for procedure. Okay, that's the button that we will come to in just a moment. We have our range, where we can switch between a bigger and a smaller scale. Menu, okay, if we click menu, there are no options currently available. Clear and enter. Enter is basically just like your keyboard key, enter, okay, like on a computer keyboard or similar things. And of course, our two cruises here, we have the inner and the outer ring, which we'll also come to in just a moment. Okay, now again, as I said before, this video is mostly on how to set up a RNAV approach for a runway. Now there are two ways, and I will show you one of them. For example, it's a procedure, like an instrument approach procedure. So what we do is we click on the PROC button, okay, and it gives us three options, of which one is only selectable at this time. Okay, it's the flashing one, select approach. Okay. Now we want to confirm that, so we press enter, and now the next page that shows up, as you can see here, it's the airport page with Delta Echo Delta flashing right here, which is the D-Land airport. Okay, and as you can see down here, you have different pages, okay, on these settings, but this is not the airport that we would like to select this approach from. That's why we have to change that. So what we do, we have to change letter by letter, although the first two are actually already the same as the ones for Daytona, Kilo, Delta, Alpha, Bravo right here. So what we do, we go to our cursor, and we use the small one, the inner ring, and turn it clockwise, and that will just flash one letter. Now what do we do in order to get to the next position? Now we have to take the bigger one, the outer ring, and there you can switch positions, yes, or letters. Now D is also good on the second position. For the next position, we turn it again clockwise, and here we have the E flashing. Now we go back to the inner ring, because that will go through the alphabet completely, including numbers as well. So A comes before E. So we want to turn it to the left and go to A. Okay, now here we have A, and now we have the last letter, and that needs to be at B. Here we go, Kilo Delta Alpha Bravo. You will see also that you have a map change here. Now, don't go ahead and press cursor. Okay, what you have to do is you have to confirm that you want to, that you want information about Daytona, and you click enter, and the whole ICAO identifier will flash again. Now remember, the big cursor here is to switch between boxes or fields, and the small one is usually to change or switch between details. But it takes a little bit of practice to figure that out. So now we go to approach with the big cursor. Here we have back cruise localizer 25 right. This is not the one we want to go. Remember, I said before that we want to shoot the RNAV 1007 left approach, so we have the small cursor. Okay, and the next box is showing up, giving us all the different approaches available from our database. And from here, we just keep on going until we have the RNAV runway 07 left. Here we go, it's flashing. This is the one that we would like to use. So once we hit that, we press enter again. And it will automatically switch to our next box, which is asking us how do we want to transition to that final approach course via vectors, like headings given by ATC, as if you're going for a final approach course on an ILS or VOR approach. Vectors, you know, I guess everybody will know what I mean with vectors. And we also have Guano Interception or Almond Beach or COCAT, okay. It all depends on how you get, but since we pretend to get vectors for the prior approach course, vectors will be great. So we hit enter again, and now it's just asking us if we want to load the approach, which will give us a picture of what we are going to fly, if we want to, if we use it, or activate if we are completely sure this is what we want to do, and it will activate it right away. So I'll just go on load, hit enter, and here we have an active flight plan. Okay, this is currently loaded. This is the approach. Runway RNAV 07 left. Find approach fixes full leg, runway 7 left, then 340 feet. And once we pass the missed approach point, direct to Gilney and then holding, that would be our missed approach procedure. Okay, and if we go to flight plan now, we'll see the white line here represents our flight path that we will be flying if we activate it. Okay, it's actually starting right here. So again, if you go on flight plan, we have the active flight plan as waypoints that we can see. We can change that. So if you click on flight plan again, we have the so-called a plan where you can say, or top-down view of what is going on, or what will you what we will be flying if we activate it. Okay, and now just really quick, if you want to activate it, the only thing you do, you press the procedures button again, and here now we have all three options available. Now it will ask us if you want to activate vectors to final or activate the approach. Since we're getting vectors to final, that sounds great, so we just hit enter. And as you can see, there is, I will zoom in a little bit, this first leg here to the final approach fix has changed to magenta color, which means this is active, and we could be flying towards that fix. But let's pretend we use the autopilot. It would turn us directly, the airplane would correct directly for the or intercept the final approach course, so to say, for our, towards our final approach fix. Once we have that leg finished and we get to full leg, we pass it, the final approach leg will be magenta, as indicating our active leg at that point. Yes, so I hope that it was helpful, and have fun flying the approaches. And remember, if you don't do it for a while with all these buttons, you might lose like your routine. So do it once in a while to keep on it.